And how much censorship is there?
There is a lot of censorship. You cannot get Google, Facebook, and many other services in China. And topics that people try to engage in, person to person, let's say talking about Taiwan or Tibetans and Dalai Lama and various religions, will be censored. They have, you know, must have armies of censors watching over the internet. But people in China are very creative. They come up with code words, and the censors are maybe one or two steps always behind the people as they try to engage in this discussion.
So the people know how to move around the kind of censorship that exists.
They are constantly trying to do that. They're trying to engage in that conversation, but it's a constant battle.
And human rights today?
Human rights, the situation has gotten worse since the lead up to the 2008 Olympics. You know, the human rights climate has always ebbed and flowed in China, up and down. But we seem to be in a down period, and it's getting worse. And with the developments in Middle East, Arab Spring, what happened in Egypt, in Libya, the Chinese leaders are very fearful of something similar happening within China. So there's been a significant crackdown on dissension, political discussion. Even the rights and the activities of lawyers who advocate on behalf of people who've been poisoned from food, tainted food and medicines. So there's a significant crackdown and repression going on within China.
What do they fear, and do they have a reasonable reason to have that kind of fear?
I think they're fearing the control, the monopoly of the Communist Party. And they see that as people become more prosperous, and especially with the new forms of communication, instant communication, they're very concerned that the people have higher expectations that the government cannot meet. And so they're very concerned about maintaining domestic tranquility and stability.
Join us online at charlierose.com.